Okay, so if the Rh negative mother is having the child, that heterozygous child, they will not survive. So we will make selection for against the heterozygous child by the recessive mother. Okay, so this is the main importance of the familial selection against heterozygous. Okay, that is very well explained by the maternal fetal incompatibility. And this maternal fetal incompatibility is what? So in on that Rh factor is it is nothing but it is some protein cells or protein cells on our RBC, red blood corpuscles. So whenever this protein is available, then we will say that Rh positive is there, and it is not available, then we will consider is Rh negative. So when mother is Rh negative, so this will not provide protein to the that particular child which has been which have has to be born. So that's why this provide a lethal com means component means this will provide a lethalness to the child due to this Rh factor. So this is all about the familial selection that is against heterozygous. Now we will move to the next, that is Wright's formula of gene frequency. Wright formula of gene frequency change. It is also known as, so this is important that one time this question came that like the adaptive topography principle is given by, so it is given by Wright, adaptive topography principle. So the general consequences of natural selection is to increase the average fitness. So what is the our general consequence? So general consequence of natural selection is to increase average fitness, that is W bar, of the population from generation to generation. And what is fitness? It means the proportion of the genes which has to be means viability of particular individual. So generation to generation, why until it reaches a on a all-time high, until it reaches to all-time high. It means which cannot be increased after any further. Okay, so means it will re until it will reach to the high average fitness, then till that natural selection will occur. So this is the general consequences of natural selection, that its motive is to increase average fitness of the population from generation to generation until the relative fitness or average fitness will reach high, all the time high, then natural selection will stop. Okay, so the setup of this general formula is genotype is like capital A, capital A, capital A, small a, small a, small a, and we will write total here, and here I will write frequency, suppose p square 2pq and q square, and total is 1. And if I write fitness, that is W, if I consider 1, 1 minus S1 and 1 minus S2. This is general setup. And frequency, so relative fitness of relative frequency after selection. Relative fitness after selection is P square 2PQ 1 minus S1 and Q square 1 minus S2. And we will make a total and we will write as average fitness. Okay. So this total will come as average fitness P square plus this 2PQ 1 minus S1 and plus Q square 1 minus S2. This is known as average fitness. So I solved it and I get this 1 minus 2 PQ S1 minus Q square S2. When you simplify this, you will get this. And my frequency after selection will, it will be P square by average fitness 2 PQ 1 minus S1 upon average fitness Q square 1 minus S2 upon average fitness. So I can write this W var, that is average fitness, is equal to summation Fi Wi upon summation Fi, isn't it? So Fi is what? This is summation Fi is equal to 1. This is just like weighted mean. If these are weights and these are our observation. So what is Wi? 1, 1 minus S1 and 1 minus S2. Okay. And what is Fi? This P square 2PQ Q square and summation of Fi is 1. So this is the general formula Fi Wi. See here, what we are doing here, 1 into 1 is weight, 1 is W1. See here, what is F1? F1 is P square, F2 is 2PQ, and F3 is Q square. Okay, and what is W1? W1 is 1, W2 is 1 minus S1, then W3 is 1 minus S2. Now we will multiply it like F1 W1. So F1 W1 is P square plus F2 W2, 2PQ into 1 minus S1 plus Q square 1 minus S2, and summation of Fi will be 1. So this will be our average fitness. See, I have written it here also. So this is general formula Fi Wi upon summation Wi. Now this important point is that if W var, that is average fitness, is plotted against our probability values, suppose I write P value, that is range 0 to 1, that will give rise to a curve. And this curve is known as adaptive topography curve. That's why the other name of Wright's formula of gene frequency is adaptive topography principle. And this slope of this curve will be our average fitness. Slope of curve will be average fitness. Now, if I want to increase average fitness, if I want to increase the average fitness, so by principle of maxima and minima, we will W, this is average fitness 2PQ S1 minus Q square S2. From here, I have taken this. Now, if I want to increase this fitness, so we will do differentiation with respect to dq, and we will put it to zero, and that will be the maximum average fitness. Okay, so for that we have to do this. Now after that, again same thing will be, we will do q1 minus q. See here, after calculating the frequency of the selection, we will get the frequency of the allele small a from this frequencies. So this and if I want to find the difference or change in the gene frequency, so this change in gene frequency delta q is equal to half pq upon average fitness and dwy dq. So this is the formula of change frequency given by Wright's. This is the Wright's formula. I am not deriving it. It is very lengthy, derivation is there. So I am not doing this. I am directly writing this. Delta Q is equal to half PQ upon this average fitness DW bar upon DQ. Similarly, if I write for P, this will be delta P is equal to half PQ upon average fitness DW bar upon DP. Okay, same formula. Now this will show the relation between delta P and slope. This will show, and what is this P? P is the proportion. So proportion is just a probability. That's why I told that the P value, if we draw, and the range of this is 0 to 1. So this this will show the relation between delta P and slope, that is W bar of the adaptive topography curve. Now when this DW bar upon DP is equal to 0, suppose DW bar upon DP is 0, then delta P will be equals to 0. And we will say that this is equilibrium stage. So that time our average fitness will be maximum. Okay, so this is general formula of gene frequency change. Now I will make one table to just show you that how we can use this general formula to, if suppose I have covered too many things in selection, like selection against recessive, heterozygous superiority, selection against intermediate in last class. Suppose our general formula is delta Q is equal to 1 by 2 Q into P into Q, PQ, W bar, DW bar upon DQ. Okay. Now see, suppose I have made a table. First one is selection against recessive. Okay. Then I will write capital A, capital A, small, capital A, small A, small A, small A. Then, so relative fitness, I written here, the relative fitness is 1, 1, 1 minus S, if you remember. So that's why I told you that this line is important, relative fitness. And second one is gametic selection against recessive. So here A and A will be there, 1, 1 minus S. Third one was selection for intermediate. Okay, the setup was 1, 1 minus S, 1 minus 2S, because heterozygous will be between of the two homozygous. Now fourth one was selection favored heterozygous, selection favored heterozygous, and the setup was 1 minus S1, 1, 1 minus S2. एंड फिफ्थ वन वॉज सेलेक्शन अगेंस्ट हेटरोजाइगस। And its setup was 1, 1 minus s and 1. So these 5 selection I have done in last class. So now we and what was its average fitness, or we can say whenever we calculate this average fitness, the sum of this summation fi wi. See here, this is our average fitness, the total after multiplication p square into 1. Okay, so if I made here directly written w bar, so it will 1 minus q square s, here 1 minus q s, 1 minus 2 p q s minus 2 q square s and 1 minus p square s 1 minus q square s 2 and 1 minus 2pqs. Okay, if you remember this brief table, then now see, if I want to find delta q for selection against recessive, okay, so formula is delta q is equal to 1 by 2 pq upon w bar d w bar upon dq. Now tell me what will be the derivative d q square 1 minus q square s upon dq. What will be the derivative of this? Anyone? बोलो, व्हाट विल बी द डेरिवेटिव ऑफ दिस? माइनस टू क्यू एस, ओके, माइनस टू क्यू एस, नो आई विल राइट 1 बाई 2 पी क्यू एंड डब्ल्यू आर इज व्हाट 1 माइनस क्यू स्क्वायर एस एंड दिस इज माइनस टू क्यू एस. So this will to cancel out, so we will remain with p q square s upon 1 minus q square s. So that was the change in gene frequency in case of selection against recessive. Likewise, I can calculate any of the change in gene frequency by using this formula, that is Wright's formula. Okay, so this is the general formula for calculating change in gene frequency. Okay, any doubt in this? Now we will move another important thing, that is Fisher's fundamental theorem of natural selection. Natural selection. Fisher's fundamental theorem of natural selection. So its statement is like change in gene frequency change in average fitness is directly proportional to its genetic variance. In fitness at that time. So, but at particular time, the change in average fitness. So this is change in average fitness. This is directly proportional to genetic variance, if I write genetic variance at that time, particular time pe change, average fitness ka jo change hoga, that will be directly proportional to the genetic variance. Or we can say that the rate of increase in fitness, the rate of increase in fitness of any organism at any time is equal to its genetic variance in fitness that time. So this is average fitness is equal to sigma square W, that is the variance, genetic variance in fitness, divided by W bar. Now this is what W bar, that is change in average fitness, is directly proportional to genetic variance in fitness at that time. So if we consider that average fitness is equal to 1, then I can say that change in average fitness is equals to genotypic variance in fitness at particular time. So this is Fisher's fundamental theorem of the natural selection. So question may come like this, that statement is given that this theorem is that. So different name will be there and you have to write that this is Fisher's fundamental theorem, or Fisher's fundamental theorem explain what. So some statement will be right, that rate of increase in the fitness of any organism will equal to the genetic variance. Likewise, some options will be there and you have to take that this will be equals to, or this will be directly proportional to the genetic variation in the fitness. Okay, so some implications, or we can say conclusions, are there regarding this Fisher's fundamental theorem. So if there is little additive genetic variation in regard to fitness will be found in most of the population. So in most of the population, if there is little additive genetic variation in regard to average fitness, so actually this question can come like in mains purpose, like explain the Fisher's fundamental theorem and its implications in 5 marks question. So that is the conclusion first, that in most of the population little additive genetic variation will regard to the average fitness. Second one is, if there is evidence of additive genetic variance in regard to the fitness, then the population will be either in transition stage, if there is means little additive genetic variation in regard to the average fitness, then we will say that the population will be either in transition stage, or we can say that components of fitness will show negative correlation, or the components of the fitness will be negatively correlated. Third one is, when environmental fluctuations are there and this affect fitness, then there is a always scope of improvement. If there is environmental fluctuations, on fitness, so there will be always chance of improvement. So these are the conclusion on this Fisher's fundamental theorem, that if there is, first one is, if there is a little additive genetic variation, then this will be present in most of the population and the fit component of fitness will be negatively correlated, or population will be in either transition stage. And third one is, you know, if there is environmental fluctuations, then there will be chance of improvement. Now this is all about your population genetics. Okay, with this we have completed Mendelian genetics, then population genetics. Now we will move to the third part of this statistical genetics, that is our quantitative genetics. This is third and last portion of your statistical genetics syllabus, that is quantitative genetics. So in this we will see the quantitative effect of the genes on particular characters. So genes which are having major effects which they are called the major genes. For example, some genes are the major effect on the color of flower, color of petal, likewise. So the genes which are affecting the color of flower, color of petal, likewise, so there will be the quantitative effect of particular genes. So quantitative characters are governed by genes. Quantitative characters are governed by genes whose effect are small, similar, and can't be visualized. Or such genes are known as minor genes, or we can say polygenes. किसी ने वो कोई have you heard that polygenic inheritance, anyone?
Yes sir.
What is this polygenic inheritance?
Many genes contribute to a trait.
Yes, exactly. So what is the meaning of polygenic inheritance? That lots of genes govern to a single character. And what is opposite of this polygenic inheritance? What is opposite of polygenic inheritance?
Monogenic.
No, pleiotropy. It is known as pleiotropy. So in this pleiotropy, what is the meaning of pleiotropy? Tell me, what is the meaning? What can be the meaning of pleiotropy? Here, one gene will govern to many characters or many traits. Okay, so this polygenic inheritance, if I say here that suppose capital A is there, capital A, small a, small a, small a is there, and I am studying only single loci, one loci, then we will get capital A cross capital A small a, then we will get like capital A, capital A, capital A, small a, small a, small a, and these are the proportions 1/4, 1/2, 1/4. When we will make this histogram, then we will get like this 1:2:1. Then if I remember two loci, so this will be like 1:4:6:4:1. 1:4:6:4:1. See here, 1:2:2:1. Multiply 1:2:2:1. So this will be 1:2:2, that is 4:6. Likewise, we will get this 1:4:6:4:1. When we will multiply this. Okay, so this is for two loci, and this is, so here the quantitative characters will govern by the genes which have smaller and similar characters, that is minor genes. So for that we will see, we will study this quantitative genetics. Now we will move to the, suppose this suppose outer appearance of some genes are phenotype. So this phenotype is the result of genotypes plus environmental effect. Okay, so this is phenotype, genotype and environment. Now if I want to see the variability, so variability, variance of phenotypic variance is equal to genotypic variance plus environmental variance. Okay, now if make I make a general setup for this study, I know this frequency is p² 2pq and q². And here if I write plus da, ha and minus da. So da is what it is. This is measuring the difference between genotype, which measures departure from departure of each homozygotes from midpoint. So this is what, this is departure. Departure of each homozygote from midpoint. So if I make a line, so here HA will be there and this plus DA will be there and minus DA. And this is parameter which measure departure of each heterozygous. Sorry, this is for heterozygous. So parameter which measure the departure of each heterozygous from midpoint. So suppose this is a line and this is midpoint of the population frequencies. Suppose it is a departure from midpoints, and for heterozygous I will consider HA, and from midpoint departure is there, then I will take positive DA for our this capital A, capital A, and departure for recessive we will consider minus DA. Okay, now important conditions are there, important result. This is important for your objective point of view. Suppose HA is zero. Directly they can ask in the question, what is the meaning of HA is equal to zero? कोई बता सकता है? If HA is not there, departure in heterozygous is not there, then it is a case of no dominance. There is no dominance over of capital A on small a. So we will not get any departure from the midpoint. If HA is not equal to zero, then we will say that dominance is present. Then if HA is equal to DA, HA is equal to DA, then we can say A is completely dominant over small a. If HA is minus DA, then we will say that A is completely dominant over capital A. Then if HA is equal to greater, HA is greater than zero, then we will say that A is dominant over, not completely, but A is dominant over A. Capital A is dominant over A, but it is not complete dominant. Complete dominant is when HA is equal to DA. Then if HA is less than zero, it means negative. So this will be small a is dominant over A. If HA is greater than DA, then we will say that it is over dominance. And if HA is less than DA, over dominance of A over small a. And if HA is less than DA, then over dominance of small a over capital A. So these are the some condition, important condition regarding this HA and DA. So remember these conditions, that is important for your objective question. Okay, now there is some interaction. If I written this P is equal to G plus E, genotype and environment. Suppose there is some interaction between genotype and environmental. So there will be P is equal to G plus E plus interaction GE. Okay, if there is no interaction, this factor will not be there. And there is a partitioning of G also, that is A plus D. A is what? Additive genetic variation. Additive genetic effect. And this is dominance deviation. So now I can write P is equal to generalized G plus E plus G, and I can write G for A plus D plus E plus I G E. So this we can partitioning of our phenotypic factor into different components: additive effect, dominance deviation, environment, and this is the interaction between genotype and environment. Okay, so suppose this environmental effect is zero, so I can write P is equal to A plus D plus I. Okay, this interaction. So this different condition, it can be asked that if environmental effect is zero, then what is the phenotype? A plus D plus I. If there is an interaction, then what is the phenotype? P is equal to G plus E plus I, interaction of genotype and environment. Now, this is our frequency p square 2p cube and q square, and this is, I will write if this departure dA, HA and minus dA. Now, what will be the mean, population mean here? Population mean will be its multiplication. P square dA plus 2PQ HA minus Q square dA. So this mean is, if I simplify it, P minus Q dA plus 2PQ HA. Remember this mean. This will be useful in next. Now, if I take the sum over all this, so mean will be summation P minus Q dA plus summation 2PQ HA. So this will be the, due to additive genetic effect, and this will be due to dominant effect. See here, this factor is coming if we take this P minus Q dA, this factor is coming from our this capital A portion. So this will be additive, and this is 2PQHA, this is coming from heterozygous, and for heterozygous we are denoting dominancy. If HA is zero, then there is no dominance. So that's why this factor is dominant effect. So for that we have discovered that P is equal to G plus E, and from here G is equal to A plus D. That is additive effect, and this is dominant effect of the gene. So this is the fraction, means I can say the partitioning of the genotypic variability A plus D, additive genetic effect and dominant effect of the gene. Okay, now if I write HA is equal to DA, what is this meaning? HA is equal to DA. Remember, HA is equal to DA. A is completely dominant over A. So I can write HA is equal to DA. It means it is complete dominance. And if HA is equal to minus DA, then we can say it is A over A, and it is complete dominance of small a over capital A. Now if I put this value into our mean value, if I put this HA, suppose this mean is equal to 2p, mean is equal to p minus q dA plus 2pq HA. Now instead of HA, if I write DA here, so I will get the range of this complete dominance A over A and A small a over capital A. That will be 4PQHA. So sorry, DA. 4PQDA. So this is important, that what is the range of complete dominance A over A and small a over capital A. So this is the range of our mean, population mean, 4PQDA. Okay, so this is important. Now we will move average effect of the gene substitution. Average effect of gene substitution. So average gene effect is what? It is a mean deviation. mean deviation from the population mean of all the genotypes in which this gene enters. Will return alpha I, that is genic value. Okay, suppose capital A is there and capital A small a is there. Now this capital A substituted to the small a, and this capital A substituted here small a. So this change is there. So what we are doing, average effect of gene substitution. So here this change is there, and we will see that capital A is changed to small a, and here capital A changed to small a. So we will calculate this, we will see the effect of this gene substitution, and we will get the offspring like capital A small a and small a small a here. Okay, now see here, now these are genotypes. Genes, everything is related in this quantitative genetics. Genotypes are capital A, small a, small a, small a. And I write the value D, departure value DA, HA minus DA. Okay. And see here, if I write the frequency of gene here, then it will be P and Q. Our earlier parents was capital A, and capital A, small a. Now, if I write the frequency here, P and Q, and after substitution, this will remain capital A, small a, then I will write the frequency P and Q here. So this is the substitution of genes. Earlier, the parents was capital A, small a. So frequency I will write P and Q. Then after substitution, it will shift here. Capital A small a to this and this. So I will write the frequency P and Q here. Now we will calculate mean of individual. Mean of individual will be P into DA plus Q into HA. Similarly here, P into HA plus minus Q into DA. This is mean of individual gene. And our population mean is what? P minus Q DA plus 2PQ HA. And same here, P minus Q DA plus 2PQ HA. This population mean we have calculated here. So this you have to remember, P minus Q DA plus 2PQ HA. So this individual we have calculated. Now I told you that this is the mean deviation from population mean of all the genotypes in which the gene enters. That is, we will calculate difference here. So I can write for capital A, small a, and this is average effect of gene. Alpha 1, alpha 2. Then what will be the alpha 1? It will be individual mean minus population mean. So this will be P DA plus Q HA minus P minus Q HA plus, it will be minus 2PQ HA. Now after simplification, I will get it Q DA plus Q minus P HA. Remember this. And alpha 2, this is important. And alpha 2 similarly I will write here, and we will get minus p dA plus q minus p hA. So this is alpha 1. Suppose now I have written this alpha as dA plus q minus p hA, this portion. If I write his alpha, then I can say that for capital A small a, alpha 1, alpha 2. Alpha 1 is equal to q alpha and alpha 2 is equal to minus p alpha. So things we have to remember: mean value. Mean value is what? Population mean. Population mean is p minus q dA plus 2pq HA and alpha. Alpha is what? dA plus q minus p HA. This we can remember. So alpha 1 is average effect of the gene after substitution. This is average gene effect of substitution of small a allele. So this alpha is showing net change from a to small a and small a to capital A. This is showing net change. So this is the average effect of gene substitution for capital A and small a. So things are related here. Now we will use this alpha 1, alpha 2 in further study. See, now we will move to our important topic, that is breeding value. So this breeding value is what? This is associated with the value of genetic average effect of both the genes. So I can write the value of an individual as measured by the average value of its offspring is called breeding value. So the value of an individual as measured by the average value of its offspring means average substitution value, and or we can say that this is the sum of genetic value, that is alpha I, of the genes carried by an individual is defined as the breeding value. Or other name is additive genetic value. Okay, so this is the sum of genetic value of the genes which is carried by the individual is defined as the breeding value. So if I write breeding value is equal to twice individual mean minus population mean minus population mean was alpha 1 and alpha 2. So now if I write capital A, capital A, capital A, small a, small a, small a, so this, the breeding value of this will be 2 alpha 1. Here alpha 1 plus alpha 2. Here 2 alpha 2. Okay. So that's why I'm writing twice mean minus population mean. So alpha 1 is what? Twice q alpha. And this will be alpha q minus p. because alpha 1 is what? Q alpha, and alpha 2 is what? Minus P alpha. So here will be alpha Q minus P. Okay. Similarly, 2i is, it will be minus 2i P alpha. And we know that alpha is what? Da plus P minus Q. Da plus Q minus P ha. So these are my breeding value, or we can say it is additive genetic value. Now, one important point is regarding this breeding value, that mean breeding value of the population is always zero. So they can ask in the question that what is the mean breeding value of the population? So it will be zero. So you have to take that zero option. Okay. So mean breeding value of the population is zero. How we will see this? Our frequency, suppose this is capital A, capital A, capital A, small a, small a, small a, and frequency is P square, 2PQ and Q square. And the breeding value is 2Q alpha, alpha Q minus P, and minus 2P alpha. Now I will calculate mean breeding value. So mean breeding value will be multiplication. P square into 2Q alpha plus 2PQ into alpha Q minus P plus Q square into the bracket minus 2P alpha. Okay. Now suppose I have taken 2P Q alpha common. So here I will remain with P, and here I will remain with, see here, I will remain with 2PQ alpha I have taken common plus Q minus P. Okay. And in next I will remain with minus Q P alpha I have taken minus Q. So see, 2PQ alpha P plus Q minus P minus Q. So this will cancel out, this will cancel out. So we will remain with zero. So mean breeding value will be zero of the population. So this is important point regarding the breeding value, that mean breeding value of the population will always zero. Okay. Now I have bifurcated this genotypic value, genotypic effect, into additive effect plus dominant effect. Okay, additive genetic effect. So this additive genetic effect is nothing but it is your breeding value. Because I have told you that this is additive genetic value. So this will show your additive genetic effect. Okay. So from here we can say this, if I want to calculate dominance effect, so we will genotype effect minus breeding value. From here we can calculate our dominance deviation, and this is the additive genetic effect is breeding value. Now we will move to the important genetic parameters. What are genetic parameters? Kisi ko pata hai? Genetic parameters. What are different genetic parameters? किसी को पता है जेनेटिक पैरामीटर्स क्या है? हेरिटेबिलिटी, genetic correlation and repeatability. So these three genetic parameters are there. So we will start with the heritability. What is heritability? What is heritability? Actually, in this heritability, we will see that which characters are heritable to the next generation. So this the observed variation in a group of individual. So the observed variation in a group of individual that is what is that observed variation what is observed variation which is visible to us what is this phenotypic variation if I write sigma square p so this is observed variation in a group of individual is composed of what is composed of genetic or we can say heritable variation that is sigma square g that is genetic variation and non-heritable or non-genetic variation that is called as environmental variation sigma square e so the fraction so the fraction of total variation that is phenotypic variation which is heritable is termed as coefficient of heritability in broad sense so this is known as heritability in broad sense if I represent is capital H square so capital H square will be fraction of total variation which is heritable so which is heritable means sigma square g upon sigma square p so this is known as heritability in broad sense and this heritability is given by Lush so I can write this H square is equal to total genetic variance this total genetic variance which is heritable to the next generation to the total phenotypic variance sigma square g upon sigma square p now the concept of this heritability in broad sense is important or we can say it is useful if the question is that this is this broad sense heritability is important or we can say it is useful if the question is that if I want to find the relative influence of genotype and environment in determining phenotype. Okay, when our emphasis is to find the relative influence of genotype and environment in determining the phenotype, then we will use this broad sense heritability. So I can say that for asexual reproduction, broad sense heritability is important. Relevant. Okay, but in case of, but if our more, if our emphasis is more emphasis, if we more emphasize on determining which fraction, determining that fraction of phenotype between parents which expected to be recovered in offspring, or that part of genetic variability that is chief cause of resemblance between relatives. So what is the meaning of this? And this chief cause of resemblance between relatives is what? Additive genetic variation. Okay, so important thing is here, suppose broad sense heritability is important or useful when we want to check the relative influence of genotype and environment in to determine our phenotype. Simple. But if our more emphasis is on that which fraction of the phenotype between parents is expected to recovered in the offspring, that phenotypic means color. Suppose color of seed I am taking as phenotype of the parents. So this will expected to be recovered in the offspring, same color, same design. Then chief cause of this resemblance? Chief cause of resemblance to the offspring, and that is what? Additive genetic variance. So instead of our genotypic variation, we will use, see here, what is G? G is equal to A plus D. So in broad sense, I am taking this in broad sense heritability. But in narrow sense, I will use this because this additive genetic variation is chief cause of resemblance between relatives. Suppose this is two offspring of the parents, this seed, two offspring, and these are resemble. They are same. So how they are same? Because of this additive genetic effect. So in this, in narrow sense heritability, I will use additive genetic variation. So what will be the formula of narrow sense heritability? Small h square is equal to sigma square a upon sigma square p. Okay, and what was the that broad sense heritability? That is sigma square g upon sigma square p. Okay, so we have bifurcated it genotypic variation into additive and dominance. If I am using this additive into the heritability, then it is known as narrow sense heritability. So it is a ratio of additive genetic variation to the phenotypic variation. So I can say here that narrow sense heritability is more important than broad sense. Narrow sense is more important than broad sense. Because this narrow sense is defining the chief cause of resemblance between relatives. Okay, any doubt in this? Is there any doubt? Okay, now we will move to the next this importance of this. Importance that characters which are controlled by genes, suppose heritability is large, heritability is high, so we can say that that character controlled by genes with large additive effect, and this is genetically divergent population. So I can say that this is controlled by genes with large additive variance. If heritability is low, then we can say that it will be controlled by the less additive effect, because sigma small h square is what? Sigma square a upon sigma square g p. So if this is more, then heritability is more, and if it sigma square a is less, then heritability is less. Okay, so the range of heritability is 0 to h square is capital H square is 1. So this range is important, 0 to h. Okay, now if h square is high, then I can say that traits are highly heritable. Traits are highly heritable. If h square is less, we can say traits are less heritable. Okay, so if h square is high, traits are highly heritable. Now, what are the importance of heritability? Importance of heritability. So first one, there are few importance which are very important for your objective question point of view. It will provide measure of genetic variation. Provide measure of genetic variation. Second one is, it will give measure of accuracy. And this accuracy is calculated by, this accuracy is calculated, it is a measured in terms of correlation between breeding value and phenotypic value. Breeding value and phenotypic value. So suppose I have taken P is equal to what? P is equal to A, P is equal to G plus E, okay? And G is what? A plus D plus E. So suppose I have taken this A plus R, remaining portion. So A is what? Additive genetic effect. And R is what? Non-additive. And this A and R are uncorrelated. A and R are uncorrelated. So if I calculate the correlation between A and P, additive and non-additive, okay? So this will be covariance of A comma P upon sigma A, sigma P, okay? Then if they are uncorrelated, A and R are uncorrelated, RAP, that is our breeding value, and P is phenotypic value. So correlation between additive value and phenotypic value, if I have written here, so this will be, if these are A and R are uncorrelated, then this covariance will be sigma square A only. If this A and R are uncorrelated, then if I calculate this, the covariance between A and R, then this sigma, this will be A sigma square A. So sigma square divided by sigma A, sigma P. So this one sigma A will cancel. Then we will remain with RAP is equal to sigma A upon sigma P. This is nothing but H, isn't it? So I can write here square root of heritability express reliability of the phenotypic value. So this second importance is give the measure of accuracy. Then third importance, it is used in predicting breeding value. Used in predicting breeding value. So for predicting, suppose A is my breeding value. So this is predicted value of A. So this will be the equation, regression equation, if we use, then A predicted value is equal to VAP, that is regression coefficient A on P into P. So this is regression coefficient of breeding value on phenotypic value. So what is the regression coefficient formula? Tell me. What is the formula of regression coefficient? Covariance of AP upon, bolo. Tell me what is the regression formula, coefficient of regression formula? Covariance of AP upon Are you guys listening or not? Sigma square P.
Sigma square P.
So this we know that this is sigma square A and upon sigma square P. So BAP, that is the regression coefficient of breeding value on phenotypic value. So this is BAP is nothing but H square. So our estimated breeding value will be H hat will be H square P. So this heritability is important for predicting the breeding value. Okay. So it is, so we can say that it is a regression coefficient between breeding value on the phenotypic value. I can say that heritability in the narrow sense is regression coefficient between breeding value on of the line of breeding value on phenotypic value. Okay, now next importance. Heritability is also, it is a path traveled by breeding value to the phenotypic value. So this path correlation is there. So A to P, if I calculate, this will be H. So H is what? Sigma square A upon sigma square P. So I can write sigma A upon sigma. So this is a path traveled by breeding value to the phenotypic value. And this H is also known as path coefficient. Now we have seen that what is heritability. There are two type of heritability, broad sense and narrow sense. Narrow sense is important than the broad sense, and we have seen the importance of heritability. Now there is few method of estimation of heritability. So there are three methods. First one is by using isogenic lines. What is isogenic lines? Isogenic lines are those lines or those parents which have no genetic variations, no genetic variability, like identical twins are there. So they will consider as a isogenic line. So for in this type of isogenic line, the analysis of variance will be done to estimate the heritability. That is not so important. So I am skipping this. Second one is likeliness of the relatives, or we can say it resemblance between relatives. Suppose I am taking the regression of offspring on parent. So what will be the regression coefficient? Offspring and parent is equal to covariance of offspring parent upon variance of P. Okay, then this VOP, and we have there is a calculation of between offspring and parent, that is 1 upon 2 sigma square A upon sigma square P. So this is what VOP is equal to half H square. Okay. So from here I can calculate H square is equal to 2 BOP. So this we have estimated the our heritability by using regression coefficient of offspring on parent. So there are different type of means combinations are there, like offspring parent. Offspring and mid parent, that is two means tedious job to calculate this covariance. That's why I'm directly writing covariance of O and P is 1/2 sigma square A. Third method of estimation of heritability is selection experiment. Selection experiment, and if S is our selection differential, between parents, and R is response due to selection. This is selection differential of the parent, and this is response due to selection of by the offspring. So this, the relation is R is equal to H square S. So from here, H square is equal to R upon S. So this response upon selection differential is H square. So these three methods are important regarding your estimation of heritability. Okay. So today I am stopping here. Tomorrow I will also I'll take class also. Tomorrow I'll take class and we'll finish your genetic portion. So today I am stopping here, and tomorrow I'll continue with the genetic correlation and other genetic parameter, that is repeatability. Okay. So with this I am stopping here.